Good morning, everyone. Today my class quantitative geography. I mean scope of quantitative geography. After all, quantitative geography is a kind of person geography and special science analysis. Here I also designed several kinds of statistical calculations with their diagrams and trend line to justify the proper result of our several observations and projects. After all, in each and every subject, in each and every stream of science in school, we have decided such kinds of graphs and designs by helping several kinds of statistical methods. So, qualitative approach is a very important matter in the geography, and not only the part of the geography, each and every branch of the geography, maybe in morphology, hydrology, oceanography, climatology, several research study, contemporary geography, remote sensing GIS, population studies, urban geography, each and every parts of the wings of geography has been designed by the statistical and quantitative approach. That's why it's a very important matter that we designed today, and also giving some concept about the topic in the quantitative approach in geography. In first of all, some specific objective in the quantitative approach. First is that it's also give you the particular result of your analysis and giving the diagram with a trend value that what should be in the potential developments. Second, quantitative approach also give you a very clean concept about the basic variability, reliability, and consistency of your performance, maybe in several kinds of product admin ratio, whatever you have been project for discuss. Third, it also give you a relationship approach with the between two approach, two products, maybe some non-variable, maybe variable, maybe dependable, non-dependable, such views and giving you a very clear idea about two products and two components that whatever you need for your assumption for your justification of experiment. Fourth, quantitative approach is approach that give you a very particular effects of your study reports, that what should be the more developments and potential ideas and potential areas for your study. And it is a very micro and macro level analytical way that you give you a complete prominent concept about your viewers, about your examiner, that you give you, you understand completely that what should be the real approach of the methodological survey here in the several kinds of research. And last of objective that in various of research technique that statistical and quantitative approach give you a very clean concept about your hypothetical adjustment, your several variable adjustment, and your findings and observational calculations with the several graphs and tendency of their potential developments. In facts of view, then what now the next topic is that what should be the real values of methods you have been used for the justify your result in quantitative approach here. And facts of view that the final sections of quantitative approach is being designed the several kinds of topic in several university all over India and West Bengal. In first of views, the first chapter is frequency distributions. In frequency distribution, there's a topic is histogram, frequency polygon, frequency polycurve, and cumulative frequency and Ogive curve that give you the complete result of prominency about the basic growth, lapse rate growth, and justification of developments with the less than and more than applicable area of your products. The second chapter that you used to hear to learn, that is central tendency, or is the value that is give you the central point of values for your authentic appreciate developments of values. In facts of view, the center in the center and the parts you will making some methods with several statistical approach like mean, median, modes with a quartile, decile, percentile, and quantile. This is a partitional values and give you the complete adjustment what you need for your partitional developments with the central points by the median approach. And in facts of view, remember that median is the best policy for the measurement of the central tendency due to several expectation of say less than and more than sections of calculation is being sectioned to give you the prominent values in the actual developments of a central tendency. That's why median is the best method for the central tendency. After that, the chapter is coming as a measurement of dispersions here. The measurement of dispersion is a very important topic here. In this topic, we mean taking for a design for the designation liability speed, standard deviation, mean deviation, and CV. I mean coefficients of variation is a very good chapter here. And there is the result of significant test here as a variability, reliability, and consistency measurements. In facts of view, in the correlation of coefficient, I mean CV, after all, correlation of variation has been designed here by the measurement of dispersion chapters. After that, correlation regression, that is a very important chapter that make you a relation between the two components, two product, maybe undependable, non-dependable, maybe and a pair of sections of rank values. Maybe the components have no relation between each other, then you will apply your rank spearman for the particular result of the R values. 1 minus 6 times 20 square into minus, and the very good formula, and give you the complete result of the justification of their value, what should be the positive or negative, and what the trend of the value here, the positive, negative or not. Then you will get the Pearson product moment correlation coefficient by the values of R, and giving the particular result of positive or negative approach here in quantitative approach in geography. This is also a very finest result that gives you the complete idea about the relation between two components that may be a positive or negative, may be positive, which type of positive they are, highly, lowly, moderately. Such a very little activities have been getting so far by the quantitative approach in geography and the Pearson product moment correlation coefficient. After that, you will getting the measurement of inequality chapters. So this belongs to locational quotient, index of dissimilarity, and the sections of Lorentz curve will give you the measurement of area and inequality for the fractions of several percentile values here by the locational quotients and index of dissimilarity. After that, you will get the nonlinear regression section. In the nonlinear regression section, we'll get the exponential curve and parabolic curve. That's give you the complete concept about the relation between variable and invariable, variable or sections of independable sections, maybe a dependable, non-dependable section of you, whatever you need for that for your product movement justifications. If the area, the result come to a nonlinear criteria, then you will use here the law, exponential curve or parabolic curve to give you the complete concept about nonlinear sections for the views of your research reports. And after that, you will getting some mapping by hypothesis tests like chi-square, z-square, and several activities. This is a technique that give you the complete identification x minus x bar by sigma, with sigma means standard deviations, that give you the complete prominence result that whatever you need for your particular identification result. That's why I'm saying all of the methods here that is being used for the statistical technique, it's give you the complete and prominency of result whatever you need for your statistical developments in geographical study. Now I'm on the next points, that is impact of quantitative geography. Impact of quantitative geography is a very clean to say that in facts of several study, maybe in hydrology, maybe in oceanography, maybe in climatology, maybe in resource study, the every wings of the geography, if you think about some result, if you just think about the hydrology, surface runoff, infiltrations, and groundwater movement, is a three topic have been chosen, and just make a report about surface runoff in your area, project report, then you have to give in some example for the complete graph with the tendency of the hypothetical approach of curve. That's why then you need some technique for your utilization. Then you will get frequency polygon, frequency curve, maybe Lorentz curve, maybe Spearman, maybe product movement sections that you apply here, and give you the particular value of the rate of infiltrations, the rate of surface runoff, rate of relationship between surface runoff infiltration, particularly in particular second. That's why it's a use, the impact that give you the result of justification whatever you need for. And last, the point is that evaluation of quantitative geography. This is very clean to say that each and every report in the previous area to present area to future potential area, each and everything, if you think you have to get some result of your future potential activity, you will use moving average to giving your assumption here, and maybe you have to data in 1 to 10 years, 2001 to 2010, you will have to justify the value of 2020, 2030, then you will making the assumption value of moving average. And also several techniques like nonlinear regression, hyperbola, and second section of views, that is exponential curve, give you the potential values of the coming future in the 10 or 5 years gap. You will giving the result that a potential approach. That's why it's a very good impact of the statistical geography in the section of geographical study. So it's a very important that quantitative approach in geography. And after that, this is a quantitative geography and the scope and content I am being done here in class, and second class will be done as a particular topic, nonlinear regression as a exponential curve and parabola. If you have a question, must query me, I must give you answer. Thank you.